Soda or water?
Well, which would you choose? Remember, the human body is about 60 to 70% water. Water is used in every single part of our body. It helps to regulate our body temperature, it surrounds our organs and our joints, and it also helps us dispose of waste. You probably already know that we lose water through sweating, urinating, and even a little bit while breathing. So it's important to replenish the water that we lose in those ways through drinking. Technically, both of these options will hydrate us, but how can we choose the best option for our health? So when we have enough fluids in our body, we're said to be hydrated. And can you guess the word for when we don't have enough fluids in our body? Dehydrated. We can get dehydrated at any time, but it's more likely to happen when it's hot outside or when we're doing physical activity and we're sweating a lot. When you're dehydrated, you are probably going to feel thirsty or tired. You could even have a headache. Your urine's going to be more of a dark yellow color rather than like a light clear yellow. You may even have trouble concentrating or feel dizzy. So now let me ask you a question. Have you ever felt like you have a headache or you're tired or you're dizzy and you don't really know why, and now are you realizing maybe it was because you were dehydrated? Anyway, so high school students need anywhere from 80 to 110 ounces of fluids every day to stay hydrated. And anything we drink will hydrate us, like any type of fluid will hydrate us. Even some foods actually that we eat can hydrate us too, like fresh fruits and vegetables or like soup. But drinking plain water is the best way to stay hydrated. And I know what some of you may be thinking. You don't like plain water. It's too plain. You'd rather drink something that has some flavor. I have my own things about water. Like, so not gonna be a hypocrite. Here's my water. Trying to make sure I get enough every day. But I don't like water if it's not cold enough. So we all like have our different preferences on taste. We all have different taste buds. It's normal. So on the next slide, I have some ideas for you about how you can maybe change up your water, make it colder, add some fruit, to make it so you enjoy it more. So you can get water from the tap, you can get water from the bottle. I know sometimes tap water gets a bad rap, but in Philly it's perfectly safe and great to drink. Hashtag drink Philly tap. But it's really up to you. Both of them will help you meet your fluid needs. And then what I want to focus on for the rest of this lesson is, how do we make the best beverage choices for our health? We know that water is the best, drinking plain water is the best way to stay hydrated. But what about other drinks? Can I have them sometimes? How much can I have? And more on that next. Okay, so think back to the beginning of this video. I'm walking over to the fridge and I'm like, all right, what am I gonna drink? I have soda, I have water. I really want the soda, but I think I should drink the water. And I'm gonna show you guys a tool that you can use to make a decision and make an informed decision. So what I like to use are nutrition facts labels. And remember, nutrition facts labels were recently updated. Up at the top, serving sizes have been updated. They now reflect more of like a realistic amount that somebody would eat at one time. The serving size and the calories are also now both in larger fonts. Down here, daily values have been updated. Things like added sugars has been added to the label, as well as down here, some other notable nutrients. Okay, we saw our new nutrition facts label, and now we're going to look at an example of one for a 24-ounce lemon-lime soda. Probably looks something like this. So where we're going to start on our nutrition facts label, and where you should always start when looking at a nutrition facts label, is up at the top at serving size. A serving size is how much you are going to have at one time, but the people that made the soda versus me versus you, we probably all have different ideas about how much that is. Especially it's going to change from food to food. So all serving sizes are different, but
what's the same is that a nutrition facts label will always talk about just that one serving. The next thing that's going to help me is where it says up here, there are two servings in this container. So now you can follow along with me down at the bottom for our little math problem. Okay, so number, or on step one, it asks me number of servings. That's just what we just looked at. How many servings are in this container? There are two servings in the container. Then it's going to ask me, how many grams of added sugar are in one serving? So I can go on my nutrition facts label. I can look for added sugars, and I can look for G for grams. So 38 grams of added sugar. Now I have to do a little bit of math following the steps. 2 times 38 is, if I'm correct, 76. Now for step 2. So step 2 is asking me for the total amount of added sugar, and I just answered that up here in step 1. So all I'm doing is taking my answer from my last box in step 1, putting it down here in the first box of step 2, so 76. Because there are 76 grams in the whole bottle, but tell me, do you guys measure your sugar in grams ever? Like, you're making cookies and it calls for sugar? No, we don't. We don't usually measure sugar in grams. We measure sugar in cups or teaspoons or tablespoons. So I'm going to teach you here how to convert from grams to teaspoons. This box here is asking for the number of grams of added sugar in one teaspoon. What that's really asking is what amount of grams of sugar is the same as one teaspoon? The answer to that is 4. So no matter what you have on your nutrition facts label, in this box you're always going to put 4 because there are 4 grams of sugar in one teaspoon. They're the same thing. So now we're going to convert. We're going to do that 76 divided by 4 to convert to teaspoons. The answer is 19. So we have just figured out that there are 19 total teaspoons of added sugar in this whole bottle of lemon lime soda. Again, there were 2 servings in the bottle. Each serving has 38 grams. We went through that first part. We found out 76 grams total. I told you divide by 4 to go from grams to teaspoons. And then here we go. Our answer is 19. So stay tuned to see what that looks like in real life.
Okay, so let's see what this looks like in real life. Here I have my container of sugar. I have my measuring spoon. This is 1 teaspoon. And I have a cup that I'm going to show you what that looks like. So we're going to measure 19 teaspoons of sugar. Ready? 1. 2. 3, 4, 17, 18, 19. So by consuming that entire 24-ounce soda, I'm consuming 19 teaspoons of sugar, and that's what it looks like when it's not all dissolved in your drink. If you only had 1 serving, you'd be having half of that. But if you had the whole bottle, that's it.
Thanks so much for listening and for following through with all of our information. Just to recap, here's a conclusion of everything that we talked about. Thanks again.